A very good evening to everybody who has logged in today. On behalf of CERIMED, I wish everybody a happy 2021. I will start with some information about the CERIMED activities. This is Integrated Wellness Science and Practice Batch 3 group, which starts on Tuesday morning 6 a.m. So this is an information. If you have not already joined in, then please join in. I'll just play a short video of our beloved facilitator, Dr. Sushil Sharma, to give you an information before we start the formal program. Another 2 minutes, we'll start. So this is a video where Dr. Sharma explains why IWSP is important for all of us. Just have a look and do get into CERIMED.in and log into IWSP, register, and you will get the link of IWSP, which starts on Tuesday morning at 6 a.m.
Congratulations, you just motivated yourself to take the first step towards integrated wellness. I'm excited to tell you that you deserve to be healthy, happy, become strong, and live a long life. What am I asking you to do? Not much. Just sit back, relax, and listen on Zoom to this seminar in the comfort of your home. Understand and enjoy evidence-based, scientifically validated practices of nutrition, activity, and secrets of positive psychology for living a disease-free, stress-free life with healthy habits. Lifestyle disorders like high blood pressure, high cholesterol, diabetes, obesity, arthritis, heart attack, stroke, dementia, chronic kidney disease, cancer, have absolutely no reason to exist in your body. You can control, prevent, and cure them by integrated wellness that we teach. Why would you torture yourself with the high cost of medications, hospital bills, and tests? Why should you suffer from the side effects of medicines and pain, suffering of multiple surgeries and stents if you can avoid that by practicing integrated wellness and changing your lifestyle? What do? We practice what we teach. We have seen the benefit of the practice of integrated wellness in our own lives. Dr. Shiv Kumar is an endocrinologist. He's been managing diabetic patients for the last 20 years, giving them the benefit of wellness, including yoga. I have been practicing interventional cardiology in the United States for the past 30 years. After years of trying to give medications, implant stents, and recommend bypass surgeries to patients, I discovered that the secret to preventing heart disease lies in changing the lifestyle. You will practice the art of pranayama, yoga, meditation together in real time. Yoga scientifically helps you get healthy, be happy, and develop flexibility, strength, and balance of mind and body. What are you waiting for? Log into CERIMED.in, click on IWSP, fill in your name, phone number, email address, and click send. That's it. Begin enjoying the fun of learning healthy lifestyle practices and feel the magic of wellness reaching every cell of your body. Bring in your family, bring in your friends, share this video on Facebook with anybody who you think would benefit. Remember, we all will be waiting for you eagerly. Thank you.
We take pleasure in introducing Reach Healthcare. Reach Healthcare works for IWSP for all the back-end support activities.
Again, very welcome to the additional number of people who have joined in the meanwhile. This is CERIMED Sunday Talks, and today we have a fantastic subject lined up, which is integrated healthcare need perspectives and possibilities. And we have three stellar doctors who will be speaking on this very challenging subject, Dr. Shruti, Dr. Srinath, and Swami Dayadipanandaji, who is a doctor by profession and manages the 200-bed hospital in Haridwar of Ramakrishna Mission. So over to Dr. Subroto, who leads our ceremony team, to introduce our doctors who are going to speak today. So with this, I close the sharing screen and I'll hand it over to Subroto Da to take it forward. Over to you, sir.
Namaste, and a very welcome to a special Sunday of 2021 to all of you for our CERIMED talks. This is the second talk in this, fortunately we are having a second talk in this month itself. And this second talk, we are changing the format a little bit. Instead of a one doctor giving the whole perspective, we're going to have a panel of doctors talking about a very, very wide and very popular and very demanding subject, that is integrated healthcare, the need, perspective, and possibilities. Actually, just last week, I came across a very interesting interview by Dr. Prasanna, who happens to be the president of FANA. FANA is a interesting association called Private Hospital Association of Nurse Association. So he projected that healthcare was going to, through a big shift in 2021, it will be going to be very expensive because it will be dependent on more technology, like you have a telemedicine, you have remote diagnostic and whatnot. And that will bring a big divide between the affordability and what is possibilities. And seeing these challenges, we thought this is the right time to talk about this integrated healthcare. It's not what we do traditionally in the hospital, but there's so many options available among all of us. So everybody has their own way of doing things. Keeping that in view, today's talk will be very, very interesting for all of you to hear. And I'm really very privileged to introduce our moderator and our panel speaker today. I'll start with our Swamiji. Swamiji is our actually the inspirer for this IWS program. He's wearing a double hat. He's a doctor by himself, also a monk in Ramakrishna order. He has done his MBBS graduate from Devangiri Medical College. And after that, he joined Ramakrishna Order in Belgaum in 2004. After that, he took the sannyas and he became one of the monks in Ramakrishna Order in Haridwar. So we are fortunate to have Dr. Swami Dayadipananda from Ramakrishna Mission Haridwar. Welcome, Dr. Swamiji. And he, briefly speaking, actually, he has served in various capacities in the hospital, including administration. He has a passion for spreading the health awareness in the community and specializes in diabetic care. Incidentally, he's also leading a DiaCham India program, which hosted by CERIMED. So, welcome, Swamiji, on this special show today. Next, I'll introduce one of the other panelists, Dr. Shruti Sridhar. Dr. Shruti is also wearing multiple hats, as you know. She's a general physician, homeopath, nutritionist, childbirth educator, and also medical researcher. He also did his MBBS from Maharashtra. And now, seeing the challenges in modern medicine, she saw that homeopathy could be give some direction to fix the challenges. He completed his master in public. She completed her master's in public health and worked as a medical researcher. She published a lot of research paper in very well-known medical journals. Also has a degree in homeopathy from renowned faculty of homeopathy from UK. She got trained in Royal London Homeopathic Hospital in 2017, and she came back and set up that interesting clinic called Purple Cold Clinic in Pune, and she's speaking from Pune today. Welcome, Dr. Shruti.
Thank you, sir.
And finally, we have the third panelist, Dr. Srinath, and he's speaking from Bhilai, Chhattisgarh. Incidentally, we have three speakers speaking from three regions of the country. That's a wonderful integration of the panel.
Namaste.
Dr. Srinath is MBBS, DNB, IDCC, and FICM. And he pursues his vocation in allopathy, working as an internist in critical care medicine. It's a very, very tough job to be the internist in a CCU.
Intensivist,
right. And position he holds as a chief internist in Spurs Hospital in Bhilai. He has a special interest understanding integrated medicine is a holistic approach. And he believes that art of healing is different from treatment. And perhaps the allopath science is deficient in that. He also loves reading, learning newer dimension of life, and listen to music. So with this few introductions of Dr. Srinath, I welcome Dr. Srinath also. So with this brief note about our panelists, I'm very, very waiting to hear their comments and their presentations on this particular enlightening subject. And I'll hand over to Swamiji to moderate and coordinate the whole session. Over to Swamiji, please.
Swamiji is, I think his connection is...
Yeah, I think he's muted.
Yeah.
Yes. Welcome, Swamiji. You can start your moderations and conduct the session.
Namaskar. A warm welcome to all our participants today for this special talk on integrated healthcare. Also, my special welcome to Dr. Srinath, who is an intensivist, and also Dr. Shruti Sridhar, who is a very unique doctor practicing integrated medicine in Pune. Dear friends, we have to think a lot looking at the present scenario. What is the scenario? As we all know, India, our motherland, is a land with various cultures, land with diverse background, and above all, population. 1.3 billion population. So imagine how difficult it is to provide step intervened medicine, so-called assisted medicine. If you want to provide healthcare to all the people, it's a big job. It needs huge thing, huge investment, huge infrastructure. So when we know more than 600 million people in India from rural locations, the moment we say rural, where there is not much development, and the global burden of disease, 2016 data reveals that non-communicable diseases and injuries continue to be the main cause of death among people of all age groups in India. There was a time where people used to die out of starvation. Now I say people are dying out of overeating, wrong eating. More than 6 million people died in India due to non-communicable disease in year 2016. Ischemic heart disease being the leading cause of death. Healthcare is ripe for disruption. Several trends are making the move towards integrated healthcare facilities. So, in brief, I want to say that we being Indians, we have got majority of people living in rural India nowadays are facing the non-communicable disease, which means lifestyle disorders, which means metabolic disorders, diseases due to wrong eating and wrong living. So understanding the scenario properly somewhere, it makes us, all of us, to think there should be some integrated approach to provide proper health services, health care to this big majority of the population. Now, what is the relevance? There is a need to bring an awareness and positivity, positively engage in this emerging area of healthcare. So as I said, when we understand the scenario, it makes us to think we should all work together, do something unique with an integrated approach to face this big challenge. Keeping all these things in mind, CERIMED is organizing series of webinars and panel discussions involving expert practitioners in this field. This is the first talk, as mentioned by Subratoji, the founder member of this great team CERIMED. So let us today understand what is integrated healthcare, what is the need, what are the perspectives, and what are the possibilities. Why we need to understand the health accessibility and quality, HAQ index places India in the 145 number place, which is lower than Bangladesh and Sudan. So we are dreaming developed India, Vishwaguru, a world teacher India, because we have the talent. India has the highest population of youths who can change the scenario, who can do anything and everything. Still, the challenge is big, as I mentioned, to face this problem. So the HAQ grades 145. So especially few states in India belong to Bimaru states, which we call, the scenario still worse. So the magnitude, the challenge is very big one. And we are in the midst of circumstances which should make us hugely responsible to support and help the situation. So we need to access, prepare, and then present to the policymakers as to where we can be a lot of help to the nation. As I understand, the participants today for this CERIMED talk are very responsible, very learned people who have got keen interest in understanding what is health, what are the possibilities that we can all work together to make a better India, healthy India. So policy making is one thing which is very important. For example, 2021, Haridwar is going to have Kumbh Mela. So if you want to have proper Kumbh Mela, proper planning, understanding and planning. So when you understand this scenario where the lifestyle disorders are increasing in number, Dr. Srinath will be speaking more how he is facing problems in his ICU when patients come in critical care, how difficult it is to make one patient all right, how much efforts is required. So if those things can be prevented by proper understanding, it will be a great service. That's where prevention is better than cure. So when I said planning becomes very important, we should have proper education plans. National Medical Education Policies. Recently, I had a great opportunity to have a discussion with eminent doctors from India, especially those who are on top positions like directors of AIIMS, Rishikesh, Jodhpur, Bhopal, eminent doctors from AIIMS Delhi, KGM Lucknow, who are very well learned, experts in their field. At the same time, they have a vision. They are all suggesting. And we also had a personal discussion after that National Youth Day talk on the 12th January, which was, of course, for medical students, doctors and professionals. There was a personal discussion which I would like to share with my people, because this is my inner circle, whom I know personally, many of them. So there, one of the director of AIIMS was suggesting, Swamiji, we should have proper policies where the healthcare providers will develop the soft skills, doctor-patient relation, how to do the administration, how to manage the patient, how to manage the attendants. So the student should be taught right from the beginning an integrated approach towards healthcare. That should be brought in National Medical Education Policies. why I'm sharing this personal incident, we also can contribute in this line. We should be able to contribute something for national medical education policies. So CERIMED has set a good directional work possibilities. Area of actions have started to show green shoots. Avenues created for integrating the medicinal streams for human good. Good programs like IWSP, Integrated Wellness Science and Practices, lead the way in lighting the possibilities. We are also fostering the practice of integrated approach with the DIACHAMS India. We need to have many such programs. So in brief, I'll be speaking more about these programs towards the end. So it is possible. Where there is a will, there is a way out. When we understand, we have a lot of population and challenges are increasing and which can be prevented, as I said, prevention is better than cure. So definitely it can make us to do something what CERIMED is doing. I really appreciate the team CERIMED doing a wonderful job and really contributing a lot. So I shall be dealing a lot in the end based on our own experience here as integrated healthcare providers, because I'm also part of it. So I shall be sharing based on my experience towards the end. So today we have Dr. Shruti Sridhar and Dr. Srinath, who have got unique background. So first I would like to invite Dr. Shruti Sridhar to present her ideas about the integrated healthcare, the need, the perspective, possibilities, and how she is working, how she appreciates the need of integrated healthcare. Then we'll listen to Srinath. Then again, I'll put my conclusion notes based on my experience. So this brief introduction to the session. Now I invite Dr. Shruti for her talk. Dr. Shruti, over to you.
Thank you, Swamiji, for that lovely introduction. And a very good evening to everybody who have joined in today for the session. So I'm just quickly sharing my screen so that we can start. I hope my screen is visible.
Yes, doctor.
Yeah. So Swamiji has given a very brief and very good outline of what today's talk is all about, and I am going to bring in my experience on the field. So I don't have a very big setup. It's a very small private clinic that I'm working from for the past 3 years since I moved back to India. And my journey started maybe 10 years ago when I passed out MBBS. So when I passed out MBBS, I realized that medicine is not the answer for everything. Drugs are not the answer for everything. We are giving palliative care, we are giving suppressive care. Symptoms are coming back again. The patient is, or the person doesn't feel happy overall. So all these things started playing in my mind good 10 years ago. Even when I did homeopathy and I was practicing homeopathy, I saw these problems. So I had one set of patients who got well very quickly with homeopathy. There was a set of patients that did not respond to homeopathy at all. And, you know, there was something else that needed to be done to help them out. So slowly, slowly over the past 10 years, I have come to realize that there is no one holy grail for everybody. There is no one answer for everybody's problem. It has to be personally catered. It has to be personally modified, and it has to be integrated in a way that helps that person come out of their illness. So this is what I'm going to be discussing today, as to how to do this integration in the most effective way, and moreover, how doctors should think so that they can do this integration even in their daily practice. Like, it is not something very difficult, and it is something that all doctors can do, and I think all doctors should do. So I think Swamiji has explained why we need this today, but I'm just going to put some numbers on this so that it is a little more clear as to what is the need today. So today, more than 90% of the 4,000 common diseases that afflict us cannot be effectively treated. They can only be managed. In fact, in US, it is illegal, or it is even a crime, to say that I can cure diabetes or I can cure cancer. You cannot say the term cure. You have to only say that I manage hypertension, I manage diabetes, I manage cancer, and these kind of things. So all of these chronic diseases that we are facing today all come under this category that they can only be managed, but reversing and curing is something that modern medicine cannot promise or cannot give. More than 99% of the 7,000 rare diseases that affect us are incurable. So these rare diseases include genetic issues, metabolic issues, you know, something in which the primary function of the cell is deranged or damaged. And the treatments are very, very experimental, you know, the gene therapy and those kind of things. So even in those cases, okay, so we don't have an answer when it comes to modern medicine. So we have to look further to what other medical streams have to offer. Malignancies or cancer, they have become one of the four most common causes of, you know, death today. And the treatment, as you know, is sometimes little effective, sometimes absolutely ineffective, having a lot of side effects and absolutely damaging the quality of the life of the person. And this is very interesting that the third most common cause of death in the United States are attributed to medical errors, iatrogenic diseases, that is diseases which are caused in the hospital due to medical, you know, interventions and drug adverse events. So it's a huge chunk that we are talking about where we are unnecessarily creating more disease while we are trying to fix a certain disease. So I think this kind of gives a very, very lucid picture of why we need an integrated approach and why we need to look for answers beyond modern medicine and how, you know, we integrate them. I'll talk about that. So I just love this word cloud, you know, it has got, I mean, this is not in any way extensive. It is just some of the therapies that are available that have amazing effects. And that also, you know, can improve quality of life, can cure certain issues. But then as long as you're aware of it, only then you can suggest it to somebody. That is what is important. So when we talk about alternative treatments or other treatment modalities other than modern medicine, we can categorize them into these five categories. So one is treatment systems, that is systems where there is a complete system that is developed over a period of 200, 300 years, or even like in Ayurveda, it's more than 6,000 years. In traditional Chinese medicine is also like, 3,000, 4,000 years old. So in these, so Ayurveda, homeopathy, traditional Chinese medicine, Siddha, naturopathy, this has all been developed over a period of centuries. And these are all complete systems. And the interesting part is that every system has something very unique to offer. Like, I'll give you a small example. When I see somebody with skin issues, I know from traditional Chinese medicine that skin means that the liver has been affected in some or the other way. And I give them a liver detox or something to strengthen their liver function. And it tremendously helps them in their skin problem. The most recent case that I treated was a fungal infection, which was recurrent. Which was coming again and again, even after giving antifungal treatment. And when I started with the liver strengthening this thing, it responded wonderfully. You know, slowly disappeared. So this is how we take the knowledge from different systems and we integrate it when we see a person to understand. So Ayurveda talks about Vata, Pitta, Kapha. So that is one way of looking at system. Traditional Chinese medicine talks about different meridians. You have the spleen meridian, you have the liver meridian, you have the kidney meridian, and you know how these meridians work together. That is a different story altogether. So similarly, every system has got something in its basics that any doctor, I think every doctor can utilize for a case that he or she is stuck in, right? The second type is biologically based system. Basically, in this system, you're using a certain biological molecule to help with the body function. So the herbal medicine, functional medicine is something like that. So functional medicine, you search or you do a panel of tests, figuring out the deficiencies in the body or excesses in the body, and you try to balance it out by giving vitamins, by giving supplements, you know, by giving probiotics and these kind of things. So this is functional medicine. Also molecular medicine is also something similar. Nutrition, aromatherapy, cannabinoid therapy, that is using medical cannabis. So all these things are under biologically based system because they are biologically active molecules which have active roles in our body. and they are used to trigger certain functions and maintain the homeostasis in the body. The third and very, very important, I feel today, is the mind-body medicine. So this works on a completely different level. I think science has only recently started understanding how the brain functions, how the brain and the body are connected, and how, you know, we can use brain techniques to treat the body. So CBT, biofeedback therapy, hypnosis, meditation, chanting. So all these things are working on that mind-body connection. Manipulation method. So manipulation, you use physical manipulation to, again, for the homeostasis, because when there is an imbalance physically, let's say a joint is in a different way or there is a muscle spasm, that affects the energy flow in the body. So when you correct that particular spasm, when you correct that particular knot, it opens up the energy channel and the entire system goes back into homeostasis. So chiropractic therapy, osteopathy, Bowen technique, massage techniques, acupressure, even yoga. Yoga is something that you do by yourself. But then what it does is basically it opens different knots and different channels in your body. And this has also got wonderful, wonderful results in a lot of issues, not just bone and muscular related issues, but also completely different issues like I would even say depression, anxiety disorders, all these things also manipulation methods work quite a bit. Then the last category that I would say is bioenergy therapies, which is again energy medicine, you can say. That is, you have acupuncture, you have Reiki, pranic healing, magnet therapy. There's also a concept of quantum healing, which is pretty new and it has come up. There are a couple of schools, I think in the US, that teach about quantum healing. So it's about using energy. There's also something called as vibration therapy, which I have not mentioned here. So it basically works on resonating the body on a certain vibration, and that causes certain physiological changes in the body. So this is just a very broad categorization of what are the different kinds of therapies available out there. And I'm sure there are many more which I have not mentioned here because maybe I'm not aware of it. But you can see how beautifully each of them can help a person get back to health, you know, get back to solving the problem or solving their health issues. Now, one thing that I want to talk about here is to understand the difference between complementary medicine, integrative medicine, and holistic integrative medicine. It's a very, very minute difference, and I hope I'm able to explain this properly. So complementary medicine means you have like a mainstream treatment that is going on. Okay, like for example, somebody has, let's say, tuberculosis, and you are giving anti-tuberculosis drugs, that is the ART therapy, is going on. So other than the ART therapy, you might have to give them something else to maybe get rid of the side effects of the ART, to you know, make sure that the general immune system is boosted. So all these things come under complementary medicine. So you have a certain, the mainstream treatment is modern medicine, and you have something allied that comes with it. Like, for example, you give vitamin C, or you give certain things to help with the liver detox so that the side effects are less. So this is all complementary medicine. Okay. Now, next we talk about integrative medicine. In integrative medicine, you are giving equal focus to the different streams. So you can use, let's say, homeopathy as a mainstream treatment for a certain problem. Okay, so let's say a person has 3-4 issues, and one issue can be solved very well with homeopathy, so you stick to that. There is one issue which might need modern medicine intervention, so you use that. And there might be certain thing which requires, let's say, Ayurvedic prescriptions for improving digestion or improving immunity. Okay, I'm just giving an example. So this is an integrative approach. Again, in integrative approach, there are two ways. One is symptom management, and second is the holistic integrative, where you get to the root cause of the problem and try to solve it. So when we talk about, or when I talk about integrative medicine, I talk about this. I talk about holistic integrative medicine, where you're trying to get to the root cause. So if a person is having, let's say, autoimmune arthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, we are not just giving herbs and medications to control the inflammation, but we are also trying to figure out why is there inflammation in the first place, right? And we are trying to solve that integration. So that is what is holistic integrative medicine, and which is what is the need of the hour. So normal integration, complementary medicine, already most of the doctors are doing. But what the doctors need to understand now is we need to go beyond that and look into holistic integrative medicine. So this is what we need to be looking at. Now, what are the different layers of integration when it comes to holistic integrative medicine? So this is something very simple, nothing very complicated. So one is associative integration. So where you try to integrate on the basis of logic and on the basis of physiology. Like for example, we know that when somebody gets measles, the body is depleted of vitamin A. So you have to supplement that person with vitamin A. So that is a kind of an integration, right? Or let's say a person is had a surgery for a fracture, and post the removal of the cast and everything, the person needs to do physiotherapy to gain the mobility back. So this is again associative integration. So we are trying to integrate depending on the logic of the disease. Now, the next thing is parallel integration. This is going one step further where you're trying to connect different organ systems. Like a very beautiful example of this is, let's say a person is suffering from asthma and you are definitely giving a treatment for it, but at the same time, you're also giving probiotics to, take care of the gut imbalance, which has an effect on the asthma. And the other example which I gave, supporting the liver help treat the skin issue. So this is what is parallel integration, where two different organ systems are treated or are attended to for one issue. Okay, they may not be directly related, but if you go to the depths of it, you go to the basics of it, then you understand that, no, this is related. This organ is related to this organ, or this organ system is related to this organ system. So you try to combine them so that there is more effective treatment that is being given. And the last is the overlapping integration, where we use different methods, which I just discussed in the tabular form. We try to also do not just physical, but also mental, emotional healing. So where you're trying to attend to different layers of the body. So not just physical body, but also the mental, emotional body. And, holistically, you're trying to view. So this is the overlapping integration, which is what we need to do, which is what even doctors need to be aware of, and the doctors need to practice. So this is what it is. So what are the challenges? I think we, Swamiji did discuss some of the challenges. So I'm also going to elucidate some of them, which I feel might be relevant to look into. I think the first challenge is the medical training. The way we are trained in medical schools, unfortunately, doesn't prepare us, at least in India, it does not prepare us to think laterally, think out of the box, think parallelly. All of my thinking growth that happened, it happened after I, left medical school and I started interacting with different doctors and starting to understand different views, read different texts. I've read a little bit about homeopathy, a little bit on Ayurveda. So when I started reading, that is when my understanding kind of expanded. So I think somewhere the medical education has to change to include these things. Like one thing, I can give you one very small example quickly. We did not learn much about the lymphatic system when we were in medical school. Like, we know there is a lymphatic system. We know what it does, we know the functions, but we did not understand the implication of what happens if the lymphatic system gets blocked, how much toxins is produced in the body. Like, instead of trying to treat the symptom, if you just open up the lymphatic system and drain it out properly using, either lifestyle or diet or whatever, the overall health of the person is improved. So these things are not taught right away in the medical school. So this is something that is wanting. And this is probably one of the biggest challenges in doing holistic integration. Second is the awareness. So it's not just among the users or the patients, but it is also awareness among doctors. Like most of the doctors are not even aware of all these holistic therapies that are available. So, and a lot of these therapies also have good evidence-based backup. It's not that it is, it is voodoo science or it is just magic. It is not like that. Like acupuncture, for example, it has got good evidence base. Traditional Chinese medicine, again, very good evidence. Ayurveda, very good evidence. But doctors are not aware that this is the scope of Ayurveda. Oh, if somebody comes to me with this problem, I can refer them to acupuncture. Doctors are not aware of that. So if medical training integrates all these different systems, even like a small introduction and what is the scope of each system, then doctors can at least refer the patients and tell them, okay, maybe modern medicine is not the right fit for you. Maybe you go find a acupuncturist for yourself or an Ayurvedic doctor for yourself. So that is what is lacking, the awareness. Regulatory bodies, again, it is something that is wanting. So the medical fraternity has got a proper regulating body, which is the IMA. For the allied, there is AYUSH, but for the others, there are so many which don't come under the AYUSH, don't come under IMA. They don't have any regulating body. So this is important because we don't know if that person is qualified enough, if that person is good enough in what he or she is doing. So that becomes a challenge even for the patients to trust. So they just work on maybe references or past experiences or something like that. So that kind of makes it a little murky, not just for the patient, but also legally, you know, there might be issues. So regulatory bodies, it's important. Accessibility. So not everybody has got accessibility to all these treatments. You know, like I wanted to refer one person for chiropractic correction, but unfortunately, there's only one practitioner in Pune and he was not available at that time when the patient wanted to consult. So, you know, unfortunately, we had to let go of that whole idea. So this is something that is going to be a challenge. Because bigger cities have accessibility, they have got most of the practitioners, but smaller cities and smaller towns, it's a little difficult. So I think in this scenario, unless physical presence of the doctor is required, we can do telemedicine. Like that is something which can be considered for the smaller towns and villages. Insurance coverage, again, is a big challenge because sometimes alternative practitioners or therapies are a little expensive. They might need multiple sessions, longer treatment, expensive medications because, you know, they are not easily available. So insurance coverage is not there. So that might restrict a person from, you know, accessing it or even asking for it. So that is something that needs to be thought about. Yeah, so I think that kind of sums up most of the things that I wanted to say. I hope it wasn't too long. So I think these are the things that you should keep in mind when you think about integration. Yeah.
That's a wonderful presentation by Dr. Shruti, and you have made it so simple. As I mentioned in the beginning, it's very important for all of us to understand by the word integrated healthcare approach means not just one doctor or one healthcare provider. It also can be a social responsibility. We should all think it's a huge thing where we need to work together. Then she wonderfully put the doctors also need to understand there are different branches of medicine which can be applied. And together when we fight, we definitely have got very good solutions based on her work, on her experience. She has wonderfully presented. Thank you very much, Dr. Shruti. To my audience, I'd like to make it very clear, as we have heard from both the speakers who are practicing. Dr. Shruti, who is a post-MBBS homeopath doctor, has found out the benefits of integrated approach in her own patients. Similarly, Dr. Srinath, who is a critical care intensivist, also talked based on his own work. I was very happy to hear from him. Nutrition as therapy, music as therapy, calling the physiotherapist
to the intensive care unit and getting the things done. So first thing, working together as a team, that itself is integration. And Shruti focused on getting different branches of medicine and working as a team, integrated approach. Now, I'll not take much time because we are running short of time. Before I take up some questions, I'd like to put my views in brief. Those of you already who have attended IWSP, you know very well. We are approaching with all the koshas, we call. So when I say this is my hand, whatever the physical body hand you are seeing is nothing but the annamaya kosha. Whatever the food I eat out of this, this is made. And this hand needs prana shakti to move. So pranamaya kosha is responsible for this body to function. So when you give a knife in this hand, it may cut somebody's throat or somebody's, it may do some surgery and save somebody's life. So there is something called as mind, which is guiding this annamaya and pranamaya kosha to function in a particular direction. And when that is trained, which we call as vijnanamaya kosha, by proper experience, wisdom, the knowledge, the direction which comes out of the wisdom is from vijnanamaya kosha. And one who is established in doing great things, guided by that dhyo yonav prachodayat, that right thinking, intellect, vijnanamaya kosha, or close to your real nature, which is anandamaya kosha. So for me, integrated approach is one which addresses the annamaya kosha, this physical body, which addresses the pranamaya kosha, the vital energy which runs this body, and the mind, the manomaya kosha, which is nothing but bundle of thoughts, which you are able to guide the mind and proper directions, particular directions in which a mind should function, vijnanamaya kosha. All the great teachers who have experienced the best things for them and for others, that they are put in Upanishads, the Gita, and the holy books from different religions like the Bible, the Quran. One who is established in that vijnanamaya kosha, once you are able to address the vijnanamaya kosha, you are going to give the best health, swasthya. Once the patient gets established in the real self, which is Sat Chit Ananda, he is free from all the diseases. So that's integrated approach for me. And also rightly, WHS says, physical, mental, social, emotional and spiritual well-being of a person is called as health. So for that, we all should work together. Why? I have a type 1 diabetic girl who is doing her MSc. She was requiring 60 units of insulin per day because she is type 1 diabetic. When we applied integrated approach, when we addressed the annamaya kosha, the pranamaya kosha, the manomaya kosha, the vijnanamaya kosha, the anandamaya kosha, which we put in one word, yoga. When yoga becomes way of life, when that girl who was requiring 60 units of insulin per day understood yoga as way of life and practiced all the things taught, her insulin requirement came down to 20 units per day. This is about a girl who is 20-year-old doing her MSc. There is one more elder citizen, senior monk of Haridwar, who was requiring 300 units of insulin per day for his blood sugars, for his diabetes. When he was taught yoga as way of life, being a monk, he was retaught to address the annamaya kosha, the pranamaya kosha, the vijnanamaya kosha, the manomaya kosha, the anandamaya kosha. When he practiced, his insulin requirement came down to 70 units per day and he is feeling better, he is feeling energetic. So I gave two examples based on my work here at Ramakrishna Mission Haridwar, which is a 200-bedded hospital where I am able to serve more than 300 type 1 diabetic children and at the same time many more adults with diabetes. So when integrated medicine is practiced between the doctor, the patient and patient's attendants and the healthcare providers in the hospital together as a team, it has amazing results. This health service, which is unique, which our people call as Vaidya Devo Bhava, that noble profession, can be made, experienced, really in a sense of nobility, when we consider this yoga as way of life, which can be called as integrated medicine, which can be called as integrated approach by healthcare providers, which can be called as holistic approach or medicine or alternative medicine, any term you use. So we have to give all that is best to heal the patient, to treat the patient in emergency. When done, amazing results. This is based on our work here at Ramakrishna Mission. So we have heard, based on the experience of the three doctors, that integrated approach is need of the hour, because our health system cannot be providing just medicine and treating the patient in the hospital. It is going to collapse. So before it's going to get collapsed and create a havoc in the society, we all should rise up to the challenge, face. So understand the need of integrated approach, and that understanding should be between the doctor, patient, patients, attendants and the great social workers. This is my message in this evening, and our heartfelt thanks for a wonderful presentation by both the speakers based on experience. Any questions we can take up? I was seeing one of the comments in the chat box. Listening to this, they said, this is patient-centered approach. Integrated approach also can be called as patient-centered approach. अरे भगवान को अगर मान के आप अपना मरीज को इलाज करोगे, उस भगवान को कैसा लग रहा है आपके इलाज से, उसके बारे में सोचो ना, वो मरीज से सुनो ना, तो पेशेंट को सेंटर रखो ना, व्हाट इज बेस्ट फॉर द पेशेंट, वी हैव टू थिंक दैट. सो आल्सो डॉक्टर श्रीनाथ एडेड दैट वर्ड, वी हैव टू हैव दैट ह्यूमैनिस्टिक अप्रोच. शिव भावे जीव सेवा, सेड स्वामी विवेकानंद. सर्व द लिविंग गॉड इन मैन, नॉट जस्ट द disease or the symptoms. Treat the patient as a whole, systemic approach. So the skin disease which is manifesting in the skin may be because of the some disorder in the liver. Treat the disease of the liver so that skin disease disappears, as shared by Dr. Shruti based on her experience. So this is what integrated approach means, which has got immense benefits. And those of our participants who have practiced IWSP have got immense benefits. Manjari Upadhyay is one of them. And if she wants to share something for a minute, I can welcome her. I am asking her to unmute. How IWSP has helped her to feel better, to gain a good health by practicing integrated approach. Unmute yourself, Manjari Upadhyay. Yeah, please share your views in a minute or two. Hindi mein, English mein, jaise aapko comfortable lage, boliye.
A pleasant evening, good evening to everybody here. My heartfelt gratitude to Swamiji, Anirban sir, Subroto sir, and entire IWSP team. So I, as a human being, as an individual, have been truly a lazy person, unorganized person, and who never wanted to get into a process like yoga. I was a person of Zumba, I was a person of other aerobic exercises, because I never knew that yoga also has got such wide perspectives which can actually turn the tables round otherwise. So I'm really, really thankful that I started practicing. I was participant of batch 2 of IWSP, got connected through team IWSP, and the sukshma vyayams and then pranayama and many other yogasanas I have been practicing for I think it's been 1.5 months now, and the results are really, really fantastic. At the end of the day, by the time I conclude my day, I find myself so energetic, so happy as a human being. finding myself a little more connected, because the perspective of yogasanas that had been explained by Swamiji here were actually beyond my imagination. Also, the food approach, the diet approach shared by Dr. Sushil Sharma had also been fantastic. So I request and urge everybody to integrate the yoga and diet in day-to-day lifestyle. I would be joining in batch 3 as well, Swamiji and Anirban sir. So just one word, gratitude. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for your kind words. Any questions, Anirban, before I take a concluding note from Dr. Sushil Sharma?
Yeah, there is one. This comment came from Professor Prabhat Ranjan, Vice Chancellor of D.Y. Patil University. So I think it is a great comment, and I'm sure that this is the essence with which I think integrated approach can only be thought through and worked through. And I think you use that word collaboration, which actually signifies this approach towards integrated healthcare. Dr. Subrata, any other question did I miss? There was a comment which I only had put that does telemedicine foster integrated approach, because earlier telemedicine in India was not approved, but after COVID, I think from April onwards, it has been approved. So does that foster telemedicine, Swamiji, as per you? Does it promote integrated approach to healthcare?
Yes, definitely. See, sitting here in India, I'm able to connect Dr. Sushil. At the same time, I'm able to collect some yoga experts from Patanjali. So whatever the things we had in our thinking, now they are abstract ideas, are conceptualized, they are concrete. So yes, definitely telemedicine has a great role. See, this IW itself, we are running on online platform, which I can call it nothing but telemedicine only. So what we are doing in IWSP, as very well mentioned by Dr. Sushil and Shruti, yoga as therapy. By the word yoga, when we understand IWSP in detail, we understand yoga as food, yoga as activity, yoga as a dimension for making you stress-free, which is cause for many of the psychosomatic disorders, anxiety, depression, so many mental disorders. So yoga for happiness, for wellness, swastha, sat chit ananda, which is our real nature, to attain that. So definitely telemedicine has a great role in integrated approach, and also I can say telemedicine itself can be taken as integrated approach. Yeah.
Very true, Swamiji. So I think that's the questions.
Now I request Dr. Sushil Sharma to put his closing note before I hand over the mic to Anirban back. Unmute, please.
Dr. Sushil, you need to unmute. Yes.
Yes, please.
Swamiji, yeah. Pranam, and my pranams to both the speakers and wonderful presentation. And I was listening to everything, and I have a new perspective, because Swamiji mentioned yoga so many times during the presentation. And I almost feel like saying that actually integration is nothing but yoga. It's uniting at the very high level. At a very high spiritual level, yoga is what unites individual soul to the supreme soul. So that's on a metaphysical level. But even at physical levels, if you think about yoga or integration as an umbrella, you can actually fit all the therapies under this and help your body and your mind. So I think that it's beautiful that we should extend the definition of yoga. Yoga doesn't simply mean doing body exercises. Yoga also means aligning you with your prana through pranayama. Yoga also is meditation, which gives you the purity and the stability and the equanimity of the mind, which is essential for your good health. And yoga also means uniting all these pathies, the so-called pathies, which are for disease management, under one roof and using that to your benefit. So it's really a comprehensive word, yoga, which I almost feel like saying that the whole integrative medicine is nothing but yoga. So thank you very much for listening to this, and it's great to hear from Swamiji and from the two speakers. And my thanks to Manjari ji, and also to Anirban and Subhuto ji. Lifestyle modification is the way to go. Lifestyle modification is for life, and the life of yoga is the lifestyle that is needed to prevent all medical problems. Thank you.
Thank you for wonderful comments, Dr. Sushil, and we look forward to hear more from you in the next series of talk. And I request Anirban to get connect with Professor Prabhat Ranjan. We can have him for our future courses or something like that, because I was very much impressed by the comment, the word, the way he put it, integrated approach or yoga as approach for treating patient, it should be patient centered. जब आप खुद एक पेशेंट हो के उसके जगह में खड़े होके सोचोगे ना, सब अंदर से अच्छा ही निकल के आएगा. तो जिसको स्वामी विवेकानंद ने बोला निस्वार्थ सेवा, शिव भावे जीव सेवा, अनसेल्फिशनेस इज गॉड. सो बी एंड मेक. पहले तुम बनो, बाद में दूसरों को बनो. जैसे आप निस्वार्थ बनोगे, आप अपना स्वरूप के पास हो, भगवान के पास हो, आनंद आपके अंदर में ही. द मोमेंट यू बिकम अनसेल्फिश, you are close to your real self, you are close to God. Once you become, you are able to make others to reach that state, swasthya. So my best wishes and prayers to the divine Lord to bless us all towards great health, and let us work all together for this integrated approach or yoga as way of life. Yoga jeevan paddhati hona chahiye, uske liye hum sab log milke kaam kare. Yehi aasha ke sath I'm very happy to have this first talk on this integrated approach, which will be being continued in a great thing, and we will be able to hear great many more people in the future. And my sincere thanks to all the participants for their patient listening. Yes. Over to Anirban.
Thank you Swamiji, thank you Subrata, thank you Dr. Sushil, thank you Naresh, thank you Manjari ji, and all the participants to come together and speak on this very challenging subject, but then the need of the hour. So please look out for our postings under CERIMED, which we'll be sending out through WhatsApp and Facebook. You can find when is the next session, which
thank you so much.
We will invite Dr. Sushil Sharma and to lead the session the way Swamiji did today, and we will have another couple of doctors speaking on that occasion. So we will be programming it in the coming days, but this will be a series, this will be a continuous discussion which we will be continuously having on this platform, because the platform of CERIMED is dedicated, has been made, and is focused on this approach to foster integrated approach towards healthcare for the mankind. So with these few words, thank you Dr. Shruti, and thank you Dr. Srinath and Swamiji specifically for your sessions today. Thank you very much. With this we close
the session. Thank you. Thank you Swamiji.
Thank you.